What's up, guys? Welcome to Daily Dose of Reddit. This is your host, Zach, and today's subreddit is r/entitledparents.
This story's called Entitled Teacher Mom Ruins Her Career to Save the Innocents. So I find myself with way too much time to talk about some old experiences lately. This is going to be a long one, so buckle up. Let's start with the cast. The OP, the world may never know. Cool teacher.
Rat boy.
Traitor friend.
Entitled popular girl. Entitled teacher mom.
So this was a long time ago when I was near the end of 8th grade, 1999. Yeah, I'm old, that's why I was born. And at the time, a recent tragedy had struck the nation in the form of the Columbine shooting. The shooting had not only put almost every school in a sort of panic mode, understandable, but also had prompted a sort of witch hunt for anyone thought to be outsiders. During this time, any mention of anything regarding the shooting or shooters was an immediate ticket to the principal's office and most likely detention. This led many paranoid teachers to actively seek out outsider behaviors and banned them. Any popular music, Korn, Marilyn Manson, banned. Dungeons and Dragons, banned. Wearing black, banned. Magic cards, you guessed it. They even went as far as to banning anything to do with Pokemon, cards, games, it didn't matter. And all video game talk, because Mario clearly causes violence. Anyway, it was near the end of the year, so my favorite class, music, was basically a study hall. Near the end of the year, there were no more concerts, so we all just kinda sat around and played cards, read, or did homework for other classes. My teacher, cool teacher, wasn't as paranoid as the others and didn't care if we brought D&D or magic or anything else as long as we weren't causing trouble. In fact, he was a pretty avid gamer and loved hunkering down on his grand piano and figuring out the soundtracks to games and then teaching us the songs. I had a decent group of friends in the class and we would always head to the back and set up some D&D or magic or whatever else we couldn't do outside the doors. Cause yeah, we were kids. Whenever you tell kids what not to do, they are going to do that 10 times harder. The class had probably 30 kids, so everyone kinda broke off into their own cliques. There was our group, a group of popular girls, and a group of sportier types who kind of drifted between hanging out with us or hitting on the popular girls. Almost everyone in class was at least friendly with each other, if not friends, except one girl, Entitled Kid. Entitled Kid was the daughter of one of the teachers and made sure everyone knew it. Her mom, for context, was one of those Karens who had to be the head of anything she was a part of. Any bake sale, dancing, sporting event, she was in charge. She had also been instrumental in the banning of Pokemon cards because, according to her, she had seen the devil in that Japanese nonsense and she would not allow the children to become endangered. Now, the only thing that kept Entitled Kid from tattling on Cool Teacher was the fact that she loved Pokemon. So, while everyone enjoyed themselves, she would generally sit with the other popular girls and gush about her Pokemon drawings. The only other pariah in the class was Rat Boy. Rat Boy loved true crime stuff. He would always use his freedom to read books about serial killers, etc. Which, it's not like he was going to shoot up the school or anything, that's just what he was into. This hobby, however, led to him trying to have many hushed conversations about the shooting or shooters. Entitled Kid had been looking for a way to end our Satanism since she had started the class, but could never find a way without ending her beloved Pokemon time. So, when Rat Boy was sitting with the sportier kids and his conversation about the Anarchist Cookbook, basically a book about how to make bombs and other inappropriate stuff, began to get louder than he was intending. She saw her chance. She immediately stood up and started screaming, scaring the entire class, including the group of girls around her.
Cool teacher, LP and Traitor Friend are gonna shoot us all. They have a gun and pipe bombs and they said they're gonna kill us all.
Traitor Friend and I had been in the back playing a large game of magic with three others when we heard this.
What the fuck?
We said in unison, no we didn't, none of us said anything. Rat Boy was talking about that crap. Which, not wanting to get in trouble, Rat Boy immediately denied,
yes you were,
screamed Entitled Kid. Cool Teacher immediately jumped in.
I'm sorry boys, but if such a claim has been made, I have to escort you to the principal and must immediately begin lockdown procedures.
So the entire school shuddered, kids hiding in classrooms with their teachers, not knowing what had happened, all because Entitled Kid was evil. as cool teacher brought us to the principal's office, entitled teacher mom came flying down the hallway.
Where's my daughter, cool teacher? Are these the shooters?
She screamed as she pushed us both against the office wall.
I will not let you kill these innocent servants of Satan!
Cool teacher pushed her off of us.
Calm down, entitled teacher mom. Your daughter is fine. There was an accusation made, and because of our no-tolerance policy, these boys must go to the principal while we get this sorted.
Entitled teacher mom scoffed.
F you, you beatnik. I already called the police, and these demons spawn will rot in prison for their crimes.
Leave now,
cool teacher exclaimed, as we were brought into the principal's office. Our bags were searched, mine first, finding a grand total of nothing but homework and a Pop-Tart. By the time they had finished searching my bag, Traitor Friend's parents and three police officers had arrived. Traitor Friend shot me a look of absolute horror as his dad grabbed his pack to empty it on the principal's desk.
Wait!
He screamed as six decks of magic cards hit the desk with a thud. Now, Traitor Friend's parents were hardcore Christians and didn't know that he had been sneaking to the store since fifth grade to buy magic cards with his allowance.
He forced me! He said he would kill me if I didn't hold on to those!
My face contorted into absolute disgust as I felt the hands firmly grab my shoulders.
No, I didn't! Those aren't mine!
I screamed as the police officer pushed me to the ground. He was saying something. I couldn't hear it. All I could do was feel the tears streaming down my face, feel the cold metal snapping tightly on my wrists, and feel the sting of my best friend's betrayal. I was in the middle of the office, on my knees, my hands handcuffed behind my back, when my mom and cool teacher burst through the door. My mom, cool as a freaking cucumber, saw me and looked up at the principal and asked just one word.
Why?
I could see her holding back the hell fury behind her eyes as the principal explained the situation. My mom, without saying a word, walked over to his desk that still had the decks of cards on it, picked one up, turned it around, and pushed it to the principal's face.
Read,
she demanded. Now, my mom knew my friend and knew he was anal about his cards, which is why she knew the back of each card had been labeled with Traitor Friend's name and address. The color drained from the principal's face, and he immediately told cool teacher to get the accuser for questioning. Entitled kid arrived a moment later, and upon seeing me kneeling and handcuffed with tears streaming down my cheeks, entitled kid's heart grew three sizes that day. She burst into tears and confessed to the entire thing, just as entitled teacher mom burst through the door.
Why is my daughter in here?
She screamed, glaring daggers at me. The principal explained what she had done, and entitled teacher mom just scoffed.
Well, he probably deserved it. Look, he's in handcuffs. The police don't just handcuff you for no reason.
My mom went off. She demanded I be released, which I was, and immediately the officers apologized. Entitled teacher mom was charged with false reporting, but because of her standing with the community, she was let off with a warning. Traitor Friend was called back into the office to collect his cards, in front of his parents, who made him burn them that evening. Sucks, but screw him. Entitled Kid was suspended for the remainder of the school year, and as far as I know, learned absolutely nothing. Last I heard, she got pregnant in high school and now makes an incredible living selling any and every multi-level marketing BS she can while staying at home with her six kids from four different marriages. But I hear she's really into Pokemon Go. Entitled teacher mom left the school and tried to run for the school board 2 months later, but had tarnished her reputation to the point that nobody would give her the time of day, and she lost hard. As far as I know, entitled teacher mom was forced into early retirement because no school would touch her after the incident. Traitor Friend and I never spoke again. I tried once to reach out through the Book of Faces because we still have some mutual friends, but that was met with nothing but silence, so screw him! Honestly, nobody knows what happened to Rat Boy, but some say on a cold winter's night, if you listen closely, you can still hear him being a sniveling little prick. Anyway, that's my stupid story. If you made it this far, then you get a cookie. Haha, thanks for reading. This story's called, Entitled Mom Wants Me to Make Hand Sanitizer Appear Out of Thin Air. In all my time browsing this subreddit, I never thought I would have anything to post for myself. Unfortunately, today, I came across my very own Grade A Karen. So, a bit of background information. I work as a cashier stocker at a local grocery store in my town that's not as popular as other supermarkets, but we still get a lot of customers. Due to the current situation we are in, the store has been completely out of things like hand sanitizer and Clorox wipes for many weeks. Because every store in the world wants hand sanitizer at the moment, we can't just order some in and have it arrive the very next day. Fortunately, we can still order regular groceries and pharmacy items like normal. And today, I was assigned with stocking the shelves in our health, beauty, pharmacy aisle. I had a pallet piled high with drugs, makeup, and first aid supplies, and I needed to get it all onto the shelves as quickly as I could. It's worth noting that our hand sanitizer is kept in this aisle as well, meaning that there's a fairly substantial amount of foot traffic coming through looking to see what we've got in stock. As I started putting items on the shelves, I had a few people come up to me every now and again and ask if I was stocking any hand sanitizer, and I always made sure to respond politely that we were unable to order any and that we hoped to get some in as soon as possible. Now, most people were satisfied with that answer and went on their way, letting me get back to work. But of course, it all turned to crap when a woman with a Karen haircut and her young child walked up to me.
"Excuse me, can we have some hand sanitizer before you put it on the shelves?"
"I'm sorry, but I'm afraid we weren't able to order any hand sanitizer, but we're hoping to get some in as soon as possible." I tried turning back to the shelves, but then entitled mother snapped her fingers to get my attention.
"This is the aisle where hand sanitizer's kept and my family needs it. Now give me some."
"I don't have any hand sanitizer, ma'am. We don't have any in stock at the moment." Entitled mother gesturing to the cart full of boxes next to me.
"You've got fresh stock right there. I bet you got some in and you just want to keep it all for yourself."
At this point, I'm getting really tired of this crap. "Ma'am, there is no hand sanitizer in this cart or in the entire store. If there was, it would be the very first thing I put up and I would have happily given you a bottle, but we didn't order any. I'm sorry." I could tell entitled mom was starting to get mad, but I didn't really care at this point.
"I know you've got hand sanitizer in that cart and I won't leave until you give me a bottle."
It was at this point that I realized that she wasn't going to listen to me. So I just turned back to what I was doing and continued unloading my cart. I figured that if I finished stocking everything, she would finally see that there were, in fact, no bottles of hand sanitizer for me to give to her. It took me about an hour to unload everything, and entitled mother refused to leave for the entire duration of me stocking the shelves. I felt bad for her poor kid. All he could do was stand there bored while his mom waited for something that would never come. Finally, when I emptied and collapsed the last box from the pallets, I turned back to entitled mom. "That's everything, ma'am. I'm sorry, but we simply don't have any hand sanitizer in stock right now." At this point, entitled mother was red in the face.
"Well, surely you've got some in the back or something. I'll take an employee hand sanitizer."
"If we had any in the back, we would have put it on the shelves already."
"I can't believe this. I'm sure you're just keeping all the hand sanitizer for yourself, you selfish brat."
At this point, she grabbed her kid's hand and started stomping off before I could respond. I figured that was the end of it, but I stood corrected when I turned the corner and I saw entitled mother having a heated debate with my manager. Entitled mother accused me of hoarding the hand sanitizer for myself and not sharing with her and her sick son. He looked perfectly fine to me. The manager told her all the same crap that I told her, and she got all huffy but finally realized that I was, in fact, telling the truth. She saw me watching their exchange and glared at me, flipped me the bird, great parenting, and dragged her kid out of the store. Manager asked me what happened, and I told him everything, and we shared a bit of laughter. People love their freaking hand sanitizer these days. People are ridiculous. This story's called Entitled Mother Slaps My Kid for Having a Different Opinion and Gets What She Deserves. Okay, some things to get out of the way. This is on mobile and English is my first language. Cast. Meme.
Entitled mother.
Daughter. My 16-year-old daughter.
On to the story. So I'm on my way to lunch with daughter, and where I was, there was a bunch of get out of baby free card groups, and personally, me and my daughter are pro-choice, but as we were walking, there's this lady who was walking up to people and asking if they think women should get out of baby free cards, and if they said yes, she'd say,
"You people can't
kill children.
We were trying to avoid her, but eventually she walked right up to us, her child behind her.
What are your thoughts on Get Out of Baby Free Cards?
I think women should be able to choose whether they should or shouldn't.
So you think we should kill babies?
Well, it's their future. They should choose and not be pressured.
You people sicken me!
And when I walk on, I turn around and my daughter is on the sidewalk with a red handprint on her cheek. Let me tell you, I have never ran faster in my life at that entitled mother, and I have never punched someone harder than that in my life. I know violence probably wasn't the answer in that situation, but nobody hits my daughter. The entitled mother just sat there in awe at me. No one hits my daughter! Hit someone else's daughter. I grabbed my daughter's hand and walked to the diner and went about the rest of the day. We had to deal with the police because the entitled mother did call the police for assault, but we got off scot-free because there were cameras around and there were bystanders that backed us up, and the entitled mother did get a $150 fine. Press charges! Press charges! Press charges! Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode.